Dear students, I am going to take the subject called Unix programming for you people. Its subject code is 18CS56. As everyone knows that Unix is an operating system, so before going to start with the Unix programming, I want to give you introduction about the Unix operating system. So first module you have is introduction and Unix files. So it is divided into two chapters. One is called the introduction and another is called Unix files. So let us start with the introduction of Unix operating system. So what is Unix operating system? So before that, let us start what is operating system. So as we know about the Windows operating system, what it does, it manages all the hardware devices with its set of programs. So like that, Unix is also an operating system, which is called a resource manager. And it manages all the hardware of the system. It takes the form of a set of software routines that allow users and application programs to access system resources. Example like CPU, memory, disk, modem, printers, network cards, etc. in a safe, efficient and abstract way. It means it has a set of programs that is called software routines, and it allows users to access the different resources like CPU, memory, disk, modems, printers, networks, network card in very efficient and safe mode. For example, OS ensures safe access to a printer by allowing only one application program to send data directly to the printer at any time. Suppose you have a printer, you want to take print out, and that printer is connected with 2-3 systems. So suppose you are giving request, all the 5 people are giving request for printing at the same time to the printer, then who will be allowed to access the printer first? So it is the operating system which schedule the different processes, different programs one by one to access the printer. So an operating system encourages efficient use of CPU by suspending programs that are waiting for input-output operations to complete to make way for programs that can use the CPU more productively. It means operating system it encourages efficient use of CPU. What it does, if more than one programs are running any resource at the same time, so it suspends one program and it allows another program to access the resource, and it allows to do the input output operation by making the previous program waiting in the input output queue. So these are the brief introduction about the operating system before going to the Unix operating system. So Unix is a computer operating system, and it is a software development environment. It is built in 1969 by Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie. These are the Ken Thompson and Dennis Ritchie, two scientists which had developed the Unix operating system in the Bell Laboratories. Originally written in the assembler language, it was firstly written in the assembly language. Later, it was rewritten in the C programming language. And the same C programming language was invented by the Dennis Ritchie. So this is the Dennis Ritchie, and he had developed the C programming language. So Unix operating system. First of all, it was written in assembly language. Later on, it was rewritten in the C programming language. Next, let us come to know the features of the Unix operating system. So it has the several features like portability. So Unix operating system is a portable operating system. Unix can be installed on many hardware platforms. Its widespread use can be traced to the decision to develop it using the C language. So since it is developed using the C language, so it has the portability facility. So it can be installed on different platforms like 64-bit processor, 32-bit processor, and with different hardwares, it can be ported. Similarly, another feature, it has a multi-user. So Unix design allows multiple users to concurrently share hardware and software. So Unix operating system is designed such a way that more than one user can access and can work on the system, and they can share the hardware and software. Multitasking. Unix allows a user to run more than one program at a time. In fact, more than one program can be running in the background while a user is working foreground. So here, Unix allows a user to run more than one program at a time. So in the Unix operating system, it is designed such a way that more than one program can run at a time. And so how more than one program will run? So one program will be running in the back, in the foreground, and remaining all other programs will be running in the background. Another feature, that is fourth feature, is networking. While Unix was developed to be an interactive multi-user multitasking system, networking is also incorporated into the heart of the operating system. Access to another system uses a standard communication protocol known as Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. So using TCP/IP protocol, Unix has the feature to provide the internet facility. So it will work using the networking system. It follows all the rules and regulations of TCP/IP protocol, and it provides networking facility among the systems. Organized file system. Unix has a very organized file and directory system that allows users to organize and maintain files. So here it all the files in the Unix operating systems are arranged hierarchically using the parent-child fashion. Device independence. Unix treats input-output devices like ordinary files. The source or destination for file input and output is easily controlled through a Unix design feature called redirection. So here, whatever hardware we are seeing in the system, everything will be considered as a file by the Unix operating system. So source or destination of a input or an output is easily controlled through a Unix design feature called redirection. Using the redirection feature of Unix, source and destination files can be controlled. Utilities. Unix provides a rich library of utilities that can be used to increase user productivity. So Unix has a different utility which has increased the productivity of the user. So this is the architecture and components of the Unix operating system.